Empty-handed, but alive in your hands. We're singing.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Just a nice little instrumental. I didn't even realize that one was an instrumental, but that was okay. It was meditative music.
Oh. Even the bird wants to sing.
Oh, you need to cover that. He gets loud. Yeah. My new one's nice, but this one's...
You know what's really funny is when we live with our birds, we don't even hear it. Like, I was talking to somebody and Larry was listening and he's like going like this, right? And I barely heard the birds, but it was loud later when I heard them recorded. I was leaving a message for somebody. And when I listened to the message, I'm like, oh, that was loud. But you don't hear it when you're living with it. Okay, so Joann, you know, are you there, Joann? You're frozen.
So because I'm getting ready to start.
Hang on, Joann, you're frozen for some reason.
I'm gonna play.
Cute little smile, but you're frozen.
I'm gonna go over technology, that it won't be. I want to pray, Father God, because everybody.
Okay, what are we gonna do here? Hang on, there she is. Could you unmute yourself, Joann?
Can you hear me?
Yes, yeah, you were frozen with this adorable little sideways smile, but you were frozen. So
I was praying for technology to work because I thought it wasn't working.
Oh, okay. Well, it was.
It's always good to pray anyways for technology.
That's right. Okay, so we're looking forward to tonight, and for those of you that didn't hear, for the summer months, at least for the summer months, Joann is going to be doing every other Bible study. And Pastor Eddie's going to do every other Bible study. So we're going to be blessed by hearing what they've got to bring to us. And there are some nights that I won't be here, but some nights I will be. It doesn't matter because you're in capable hands with two other ministers here. So we're all good, right?
Yeah,
so share this, let people know that what we're doing. And Joann, I think you're frozen again, unless you're just making a face.
Can you see me moving?
No, you're kind of making a silly face.
Oh, well, I pray we don't have any problems with that, y'all. And I'm excited to be here, and I'm excited to see everybody that does come, and I miss those that don't come. So I praise the Lord for y'all here, and I pray this message will bless you. I was going to ask Karen, do you want to do the reading, or you're not up to it tonight?
Not tonight, love.
Okay. So Fox got it. So we're covered either way.
Okay, Joann, just go off video and come back on video. Then that should unfreeze you.
I'm all the way up.
Oh, didn't have to go off. Okay. It's all good. So what's new, guys?
You're alive.
Okay. So, so it's a Bible and we're going to study. I don't know. No, she'll be back. Bible study. she's prepared. So she's just going to come back. And here we go. Hallelujah. I don't know why it was freezing. I don't know. Mike is okay.
Huh?
Mike is okay, so why is she freezing? Okay, now you gotta put yourself back on there, girl. There you go. Hey, we don't want to see you two getting friendly. What's going on there?
he was tickling my head with his goatee. I'm like, I got it.
Okay, so now if you can just move your camera down a little bit so we can see your actual face. Totally.
Yeah. Is that good? Is that where you need me?
You're perfect. We need
all
to
right.
see your face. All right, now, go ahead. Go start and
do you have
good.
My papers? Oh, here they are. All right. Praise God. Well, Pastor always does a good job picking songs. And because I like the way she does it, because it'll go with the theme. And by the songs that you heard, I'm going to be talking about victory in Jesus, because we all know here that the enemy's been trying to attack us any way possible to not get us to come to Bible study, to not focus on reading the word, to not, you know, be prayed up. And it's very important when you do these things to be prayed up and studied up during the week, as well as when we get together, you know. And even when you don't have a, like in my case, when I don't have a study, I'm still studying. Amen. So I'm praying that this will give us all wisdom and that we'll come out real positive, because I love that topic that God gave me, is victory in Jesus. And when I was praying about it, because I have to share this, when I was praying about it, I said, Karen, someday you're going to give your testimony. So I'm going to start talking about it now, because I receive mine and I receive yours. Amen. So that's the way I'd like us to look at that tonight, that we have victory because we serve a victorious God. Okay. So I'm going to start out with the first part, and there's five different ways to have victory in Jesus. So the first one I want to start with is courage. And he's going to read a verse to go with that. And then I'll talk about other things as well. So I need the first one. Okay. You sure you don't want to rewrite this on a paper? Okay. He's got it on. He put it on the tablet. I'm still old school. I still do my notes and stuff. We can't hear you. We can't hear you.
Okay. Psalms 118, number 6. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me?
Amen. And we got to keep that in mind now, because, you know, I told a friend of mine, I really saw that we would see part of the end times before it came, not that we're going to be at the very end. You know, the goal is to be ready. But, you know, if we're not strong now, how are we going to be as the end times get closer? You know what I'm saying? So our focus has to be on our faith in God. We can't let that go. It's so important that we realize it's not by my might, but by his that saith the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So that's what we're going to keep in mind. And I wrote down an example here, and then I'll see about where you guys have noticed that the courage of God helped benefited you after I read this part. And it says, it talks about Jesus, that he helped Joshua, tell him to meditate on his word night and day. An example is Jesus helped knock down the walls of Jericho. So have you thought about your walls of Jericho, your personal walls that you believe God can knock down or has knocked down? So I'd like to ask you all, in cases of that you've seen in your life where God has helped you with courage, because this strengthens us as a group, as a family of Christ. So does any of you have an idea of where God has used you for courage? All right, Annette.
years ago, I mean, not too long, I had an opportunity to share my testimony in front of the church. I actually offered myself, and I said to myself later, what did I do? But as soon as I went in front, the Lord took over, and I did my testimony, and later people said that was really, you know, the Spirit was really on me. So I have to say, when you need to do something, you do it afraid, and he will give you the courage.
Amen, and you're so right, because you would never know, because I'm outgoing and funny, you would never know that me being a speaker was hard on me. I've done it in churches and it was still hard. And then I had this platform and I'm like, it's still hard, you know, but I say, God, I'm not going up there, you know, on my own will. I'm going up there with the Spirit of the Lord helping me, you know, and it's like I said, being prayed up before I even do this. And you'll notice that when you are obedient to God, it's like the words coming out of your mouth just flow natural, you know, like you, you almost don't know what you're going to say, and it just comes out real natural. But when you think about things and you got to do something else that's not related to God, another speech, then you could be like stuttering and all kinds of stuff can happen. And I know that I've been, this is a testimony, but you know, as far as courage goes, like, it was harder for me to even do these studies, but I wasn't going to let the enemy win because I had a concussion last year and my memory went really bad, you know? So this year I was like, I'm going to play Scrabble. And I started making that a daily thing, and it's causing me, it's really helping. So if anybody's having memory problems, I would really recommend that because it's really helping me focus better. So I still do the other things for God, but sometimes when I feel like I'm having a little issues, I'll go and play, and it's helped. But the courage he gave me is that when I get up there and I pray, like when I do these studies with Karen, I don't plan on what I'm going to say. I plan on the verses, and I let the Holy Spirit go from there. So it just comes smoothly. Like when I was talking before this first stages of my concussion, it wasn't smooth. I'd be like stumbling over my words, reading or writing things backwards, just all kinds of stuff. But God will give you the strength, you know, to do what he asks you to do. He will not ask you to do something unless he prepares you first. So does anybody else have a story about courage, how God used them? I just want to give everybody an opportunity to participate.
I used to be afraid to talk about the Lord in front of my family because they're non-believers. And the Lord has given me a lot of courage through the years. I talk to my dad more about the Lord. I talk to my mom more. They might not be really open to receive it, but at least they're listening. So I'm glad, and I pray that the Lord would give me more courage to do that.
Amen.
Good.
And if you're stuck in translation, call me and I'll help you talk to them.
That's what they're saying.
So you know me, the offer's always out there. Your mom already likes me, so that's an advantage. Karen, this is up to you how much you feel you're able to talk through tonight. Do you want to talk about your courage while you were in the hospital up to now? Because that took a lot of courage, what you went through.
I'm not prepared to do that yet.
Okay, that's fine. Because I know a testimony's coming beyond seeing this oxygen. Because the way I look at it is you made it home. And that's the first step. And I'm praising God for that. Amen?
Yeah. Yeah. She did say that she had some problem. You know, like when you can't breathe, you don't have a lot of air in you. The more you talk, the harder it's harder to breathe. So
yeah, that's why I asked if she can do that.
Look, I have a little testimony of courage that I wanted to share. I don't know if I'm going to stay on through the whole thing, but when my father was dying in the hospital, and that was really, 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 really hard. But we had an opportunity to have courage during his dying time. He went in the hospital like the September 1st, he died September 30th. So for a whole month, he was in there and going through a lot. He had strokes and all this stuff. But anyway, so it took courage to talk to the people that were around us and the nurses and everything about our faith and how, you know, Jesus could heal them, that Jesus loves them, that he's their savior. While my father's laying there dying, that was took a lot of courage to kind of be able to talk about that. And I've mentioned before that we actually brought the chaplain there to a close relationship to Jesus Christ that person never had before. And they were shocked. They kept saying, you know, it's blowing us away that you have the courage to be speaking of the Lord during this terrible time that you're going through. So I think that was a very hard time, but yet God gave courage to do it because it was his will that get done at that moment. Sometimes it's not easy. It's his will, but it goes against our will, right? We don't really want to sometimes. But if we do it, God blesses it. Okay, that's my testimony.
Amen. That's beautiful. I love hearing people's testimonies because it really makes, it strengthens me. I get excited to see what God has done, you know. Mm-hmm. And we all have a story to share. All of us do. Okay, for the second one, it's going to be on obedience. So can you read John 14, 15, please?
John 14, verse 15. If ye love me, if you love me, keep my commandments.
Amen. So that's being obedient, because if we, like you were talking about, Pastor, if we try to do things our way and it's not God's will, nothing's gonna good's gonna come out of it. It's gonna just, everything will not go smooth for you. Whatever can happen will happen. But when we leave it in God's hands with our faith and trust in him and be obedient, he will make our path smooth. Amen. So I have an example here where I'm trying to read my writing, y'all. Excuse me. He helped Joshua through Gideon. Jesus and his people, through obedience, what did they do? The Mennonites were defeated, resulting in victory. Amen. Because how scary would that be to be called for to go to war? I'm so happy that I don't have that on my head, on my mind, to have to go to war. But can you imagine how Jesus helped, you know, the people, because they were being obedient, said what they were going to do, that they defeated. They defeated it, you know, and took back what's theirs. In fact, that's why we could celebrate today, because that's one thing about Israel. The people were the ones that had faith and followed God, had so much faith. And that's why we can, you know, celebrate Purim today, you know, because God gave the victory. And I praise God for that. But it took a lot of faith, because it's scary to go to war. Amen. So the third one's about faith. Oh, before I get into that, can you think of a story about where you've been obedient, whether it was easy or out of your comfort level, and how you felt like you received victory because you listened to God, how it favored your life? Anyone?
Pastor and my dad.
We can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Pastor and my dad until he finally said that he did the sinner's prayer.
Yeah, he said, Joann, this was so funny at the picnic, even though I got sick after, but glory to God, I made it through the picnic. He goes, Joann, so are you still studying to get your pastor's license? And I said, well, I got it. And he goes, well, shoot. We've been praying for him, minded, you know, and he said, shoot, go ahead, preach. So I started talking to him. And he received it all real well. Praise the Lord. Maybe he didn't want to hear it from Mike, but he received it from me. And it doesn't matter who God uses. Not really. He'll use who he needs to use to make a difference. I praise God that all our prayers, that's the testimony, have been answered with his dad.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So we have so many testimonies. I could do a night on testimonies, but I praise him. So anybody else want to talk about obedience to God? Last chance, and then I'll move on. Drums.
I do want to say.
Okay, go ahead.
I do want to say something on the last one that we had. We talk about having courage and stuff. If you think about it, all the saints, all the, you know, the apostles, they had extreme courage going against everybody. You know, especially once Jesus was gone, everybody was against them, and they went through some terrible times. But you know, they kept true to the faith, and you know, all the way to, you know, become martyred for it. But still, you know, they had the courage to do that, and that's the way we're going to need to do too, because the possibility that might end up happening to us too.
They kept trucking for Jesus.
Because it doesn't say anything about, you know, everybody else says, you know, God won't give you anything that you cannot handle, but that's in a way it's more or less true, but it's not totally true, because I mean, you know, the He'll put you through, you know, he'll allow you to have to go through a lot of things like he did his saints. You know, they went through some horrible things, but, you know, it was worth it in the long run, you know, because God defeated death. That's one thing people don't realize. That's the worst thing that can possibly happen to you, is you're going to die. The enemy will kill you. But guess what? Your body's going to die anyway, so it doesn't matter. Live for Jesus. You know you're going to live again.
Don't jump too far with my message.
Okay, I'm smart.
Hey, Larry, is that something? Joann, Larry.
Hi.
Hey, Larry.
Good to see you. Larry has something to say. Larry.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Some of you probably heard it when I was giving my testimony, but I was in a situation where I was, center, and I went in there voluntarily just because I needed the help and I knew I needed the help. And the counselor was a rather 6'6", 285 pounds, and he told me that in order to get through this course, I had to acknowledge the fact that I needed to take my wedding ring off and not wear it anymore.
Ooh.
Well, that didn't really go really well for me. So I was out in the courtyard and I'm talking to everybody about God. And I said something that I repeated to the counselor. I said, you know what? I'll take this wedding ring off that day God whispers in my ear to take it off, because that's not the will of God. So I went back into the next day. I go back in, I have my coffee, I'm sitting down, and he's glaring at me. Right? He says, I thought I told you to take that off. I said, well, you did. I said, but I went to a higher power than you. And I found out that if God would have wanted me to take this ring off, he would have whispered it in my ear. And since he didn't do that, and it's not who God is all about, I'm not doing it. And if I have to leave today, I will leave today, but I'll follow God first before I follow man's interpretation of what's good for another man. And I think he was just shocked enough that he just said, sit down. He didn't say get out. He just said, sit down. Right. But I took the chance that I was going to get kicked out that day. And you know what? If I get kicked out doing what God wants me to do, I'll walk out voluntarily. You know, you don't have to kick really hard. You know, I'll just walk out very carefully, because I follow what God whispers in my ear. And sometimes it goes against the grain of an awful lot of people, against the grain of an awful lot of ideologies that, people have. But none of that matters to me more than what God thinks and what God tells me what to do. And it will always be that way, no matter what pain, no matter what I got to go through. I'd rather go through it than fall through the chasm on the last day. I'm staying away from the chasm. As you can see, I get well tanned, so I don't need to dive into the fire. Right? You know. But I will go wherever God is leading me to, and whatever he's telling me to do, I will do. Mm-hmm. So that's my courage spoke.
That is an awesome story.
You scared that guy.
Well, I think he was like, well, there's nothing I can say. He's going to do what he wants anyway. But you know what?
He's got God's authority. Who am I to say anything?
No, that was good food for thought. Mm-hmm. Because obviously what you did worked. Because you listened to God.
Obviously you heard my testimony.
all those years in that he's been teaching and studying psychology, you know, he had to step back and say, well, that's a new one for me. Mm-hmm. So kudos, God taught him through that. Mm-hmm. Amen. So yeah, that's a very good story. Yes, Patty, you had to turn your, I can't hear you. You got to turn your thing down. Okay.
Yeah. When I was getting checked in for surgery, it says faith can move mountains, which was Matthew 17:20. I don't know all the verse. And then when I got through, we went to my son's girlfriend's house. And her mother had a piano that belonged to her grandmother. And I said, well, may I play you a song? And usually when you're under anesthesia, you don't do all kinds of stuff like that. But I just happened to volunteer to do that for him. And the song that came out was Faith of Their Fathers. And it was corresponding with the scripture that morning that was given. So I thought that was very interesting that how that came all about. You know, it was...
That's awesome. That's like confirmation. Now, the verse, are you thinking about if you have faith the size of the mustard seed, you could tell that mountain to move and it will move?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I love that one.
That was Matthew 17:20, but it was like corresponding with the faith of our fathers, you know, and that belonged to her grandmother. I don't think they have played that piano a very long time. So I felt very pleased to play for them, but that was the first song that came out was that one there. So
that is awesome. To encourage yourself, Patty, is when these awesome things happen and you see how God's working your life, journal it.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah,
because at the end of the week you'll go, wow, I didn't notice all these things that added up to something pretty big.
To do it, but it was a blessing for me, but I could tell that they needed it that day. I could tell. So
amen.
Yeah.
That is awesome. I love it when God works that way. That's one thing about why I love to teach so much, is because as I teach you, God is teaching me. You know what I'm saying? So I learn with you guys, and it's a blessing. Mm-hmm. So now anybody else want to add anything before I go talk more on this? I'll make sure I don't leave nobody out. Okay. I saw Mary there. So hi, Mary.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Mary.
I'm glad to see you. Missed you. So the next one we're going to do is faith. And that will be First Thessalonians
5:24.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it.
Amen. So that's the way I think when I'm in the hospital. And y'all know I've been through and still going through. And I keep saying, you know, God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. And that goes along with my faith. And I notice that when you speak Bible verses over you, it's real powerful and has a calming effect. So I definitely would recommend that. Like, you know, I'm like, the joy of the Lord is my strength. God gives me faith that surpasses all understanding. And I would pray, I would actually say that, and I even pray it over me. So not just to learn, but utilize it, the word. And so an example I have on faith is, you know, we all know the story about David and Goliath. His brother Saul tried to discourage him, but he had so much faith to do what God told him that he didn't even, nowhere in the Bible did I read that he looked at his size as a problem. Like, he just got up there, got a slingshot ready, and went with it and took him out. Can you imagine, with one stone between the eyes? But, you know, that is a faith that I'm like, God, I want this type of faith that no matter what I go through, I'm going to work for you. I don't want anything to hinder the destiny that you have for me. Because the enemy will take it under your feet as fast as he can grab it, you know. And I don't know about you, but I'm like, I say this every day. I'm like, you got no place in my home, so choke on it. Go out the door. You don't have a place here, you know. And I say with authority, because I know God gives us authority. So I'm like, you know, I got a lot going on in my life, so I'm not going to let him add more to the, you know, to situations. So that's something I've been talking about, friends, too, that we ask God to teach us to be more positive in our thinking. Because it'd be like, God, how do you want me to look at it? Because if you think about it, human nature can take us downhill real fast. We can spiral real fast when we're going through. But we ask God, show me how you see things. Then whatever we're going through becomes easier, because God has answers that we don't, or perspectives on ways that we don't look at things. So now I'm on Does anybody want to see? Before I get on the next one, does anybody want to mention about faith, about how your faith in God had proved a good result? You know, like what God asked you to do, or what He's done for you, that, or something that you, because you believed in Him, you learned something amazing to share with us.
Karen,
you
want to
talk about? Okay, go ahead, Karen. I can't see you, hon.
Huh?
Did you have something to say?
No.
Oh, Larry said it. Sorry to put you on the spot.
She had her hand raised, so.
Okay. She's probably saying praise God, because both of us do that a lot when we're talking. We have our praise hands up. And, well, I'm Hispanic anyway. I can't talk without moving, but I know Mary likes to share things. So I'm going to just bring it up. Mary, you're a woman of faith, and I know you're a woman of faith. Is there a story you would like to say about your faith and how God moved for you?
Yes, yes. I have a lot of testimonies. Indeed, I have a lot of testimonies. Here I am today. If I remember, maybe 2 years ago, where I was,
amen.
I reached the stage whereby I started meditating the word of God, talking the word of God, because I had no one to tell except only God. I started to speak. Even if I could see the rain, I could say, "You rain, you are the servant of God. Wash out whatever the giant, whatever the dust, whatever the name, the quality, be it COVID-19, wash it out in the name of Jesus. So shall it be." I have the authority even to speak with rain. I don't know how it comes, but I just found myself speaking with rain.
Preach
that Holy Spirit work through you. That Holy Spirit work with you to be a mighty warrior for Christ. Amen. You know, so that's a blessing. I could listen to your go ahead, keep talking, because I can listen to your testimonies all day, Mary.
Okay. Well, okay. Sometimes I could speak with F. I could kneel down and speak with F. I said that Jeremiah chapter 22, verse 29. You F, three times, hear the word of God. The word of God say that whatever I speak with my mouth, declare with my tongue, it shall come to pass in the name of Jesus.
Woo!
Yes. So
we're having church.
I could speak with rainy. I could speak with the earth. I could speak with the north, the west, east, and the south. That whatever I speak shall do what I want it. I send it to do, not return back without doing it. Sorry, my language is.
I understand. Everything is perfect. Yeah. And not only that, you're speaking it in faith. You know, like we were saying, faith makes a difference, because faith without works is dead.
Amen.
And so we need to remember that we need to activate what the Holy Spirit gives, you know, the gift of the Holy Spirit gives to us. We need to activate it. And I don't know about you, but, oh, Lord, I need to come down from that. I had church. That was wonderful. So.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you.
Thank you. So the next one's on unity, that reason why we're here today. So Mike, can you read the Corinthians 5:11?
You guys have no volume.
The devil's a liar.
Okay.
Philippians 5:11. Wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do.
Amen. So like we try to strengthen ourselves day by day. Oh, another day I can do it. I can make it. I can do it. Well, God wants us to do that as a family of Christ. And like, if any are discouraged and you know that, you come to me, you know, just talk to me, cry with me. Good do. I mean, I'm the first to grab, you know, Kleenex sometimes when people are crying with me. I join them, but because you know, when you love the Lord, you feel what each other feels, and you want to strengthen each other. And I'm like, it don't matter what you're going for. That's what we're here. We're family of Christ. So if you need me, reach out. Sometimes I'll send out prayers or whatever, you know, or are you okay? Little things like that. And it doesn't mean that I have to write giant books. If you want me to, I probably could, but just to know that, you know, you're there and you care and that you're the, you know, that you're another, you have an ear. Like the way I look at it is, as long as I can hear, I've got an ear for you. Amen. Cause God's blessed me with that. So what has unity done for you with these Bible studies and in your life?
Can you repeat that, Levin?
Sure. How we're doing these things and having unity in Christ with Bible studies and friendships that we've made and all that. How has that helped you? Especially, I want to stress Christian friends, because the world is not going to give you what you need. So what has Christian friends and situations done in your life that made unity better? How has it improved your life?
Now I'm going to say something.
Yay.
I sell, you know, most of you know that I sell baby clothes on Facebook, and I am just who I am throughout. And I didn't realize that there were so many faith-filled Christian women in the Reborn community. So I've met a lot of new people, and sometimes I'll go on live and the Holy Spirit will stir up my heart. And I say, somebody needs prayers right now. Somebody's going through something. And I start praying. Mm-hmm. And it is so nice to see that because I'm authentic in who I am in the Lord, people are the same way with me. So I've met a lot of new people and have formed really great friendships.
Amen. Love hearing that. And I witnessed it too. I feel like her little cheerleader and everything she does. I'm like, if I don't buy something to help her out, this is so funny. I'll mention how awesome something is that I don't buy, and usually she'll end up selling it. So I'm like, we're like tag team things going on. It's pretty good. But see, that's what we, like I said, little things we can do for each other to make a difference. And her and I will joke around as she's doing her sales and stuff. And people like that, they'll join in. So it's like a fun, safe place to come to, like we're creating here. And that's very important. That's what, when I think of unity, that's what's special to me, is to be able to have a safe place to go to. Because, you know, the world is not that. They're not going to provide what you need in a godly way. And so when we have each other as a family in Christ, it seems like you don't have to fight so hard to make things work as hard. You don't have to feel like you're running in circles and getting anywhere. You could just pick up the phone or pick up or send a text, you know, and just say, hey, you know, you want to talk, whether it's me that needs it or that person, you know, that you feel in your heart discern that they need it. So just that goes back to obedience with God, which we talked about earlier. So I'm going to call on Mary because she's such a good talker. So, Mary, how is the group, the family group of God, with you?
Pardon, please. Pardon. Come again.
I said, the unity you feel, the family of God here. How has it helped your life having this unity?
Indeed, this is it is a divine connection. It is by God intervention. Indeed, it is divine connection. Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. That's right. We can't give credit.
Mm-hmm. You are like my parents. You are like my sisters, my brother and sisters, my parents. Indeed, it is by divine connection, this family.
Yeah, we love each other very much. When one of us suffers, the other one is there to back them up. And I like, that's very important in the body of Christ. There's a lot of churches, but that doesn't mean there's assembly like it needs to be. Assembly is very important. And so I do. I thank God for every one of you guys, you know, when we could assemble. I love it. I'm always looking at Annette's, like, you know, her little study she does. And I'm always looking at her little comments. And you know, those things make my day, you know. And I know that she knows someone's watching them. That makes her day because I'm giving her thumbs up. And, you know, and that's one way of support, too. Because some of us may not be chatty Cathy's like me, you know, but you have, everybody here has an important thing they can do to share and to show you care, because this is the way I look at it. If we could show God's love and unity with each other, how much more can we with the world? Because it's got to start with each other. It's got to start with the household and then the body of Christ before we can go out and show that love anywhere else. Amen.
Amen.
So my last one, unless anybody else has anything about unity they'd like to add, I'm giving you one more chance. Drum rolls. Okay, the last one is the whole topic that this is about for the fifth step. Victory in Jesus. That's what we're talking about. We did all these things, the courage, the obedience, the faith, unity. Now we're in victory. Amen. So that's 1 Corinthians 15:57.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Verse 57 is, but that, there it is. 57. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
I love that. Because a lot of times we think of God as being our recruiter. We know that God's our creator. We know that Jesus, because of him, we have victory. But all things start with God and through the Father, through Jesus, we can say we have the victory. Because they're not one body, but they're one mind and one accord with everything they do. So we need to realize the importance of the Trinity in that way. You know, value all, love all, appreciate the whole triune, you know, because it's all important. And the example I had there is when Jesus defeated Satan on the cross, which we know that, and he defeated him through resurrection. And from there, we have gotten forgiveness of sin as a result. Every knee will bow and every tongue will confess at the end that Jesus Christ is Lord, because guess what? We're waiting for the last days, but Satan was already defeated when Jesus resurrected. He already done deal. It's in the plans. Wash your hands. Say praise the Lord, because you've got no place. Get out of here, you know. So I praise him for that. So where are areas in your life that you felt God help you get victory on things? We all have a brag story. Come on now. God has done great things for us. Okay. In it,
I know he helped me to overcome. I was a very, very timid person. Okay, I wouldn't be able to look at people, or even doing my devotion. So I thank the Lord for what he's done there, because I overcome that. Where now I could look at people.
Blood of the Lamb.
I could look at the people in the eye. I could do what I'm doing now. I would never think, years ago, you would have told me that. I said, take a hike. But I just want to give the glory to the Lord for that.
Amen. So now instead of take a hike for doing something, you told the devil to take a hike from preventing you from doing something. Amen.
Yes.
There you go.
Yes.
Would anybody else like to talk about their victory?
I got 13 years of counting.
This is real. I'm this is who I am, my personality, and I love y'all who can accept it. So go ahead.
I got 13 years of counting the sobriety, so
Amen.
Couldn't have done it without him.
Let me tell you, he tried a lot of times, and I'm like, you know what? I'm not gonna have anything to do with you if you're gonna drink. I was like, I know you love God, but that's a no for me. And so he woke up the next day and he said, God, I don't want this anymore. And would you believe he never drank since that he said that prayer? One drink, he didn't get sick. He didn't have any.
I was an alcoholic and a half. Love the drink.
Yeah, I went to see him at his old roommate's house and his head was split up. And I said, what happened? And he goes, I was practicing my drunk walk. And he really was.
I guess I need more practice.
You know, and thank God he can walk now, you guys, because that scared me, you know. But it took me to be bold, which that was God, because those that know me know that I'm kind of don't like confrontation at all. Mm-hmm. I can't deal with it very well. God is going to teach me, but I don't do well with it. But something got a hold of me and said, "You got to end. This got to be done." And he said he had no cravings for it when he took it to God. Yep. That is a beautiful story, and it was real, not just a story.
There was no AA either.
Nope, didn't go to AA.
We don't do that. We don't do that somehow or higher power. There's only one higher power.
Amen. That's right. So anybody else have something to add before I do the last scripture?
My sister wants to say something.
Oh, yeah, please do. I love hearing all your stories. You just totally strengthened me. I love that.
It started, I am an alcoholic, and I haven't touched it for 35 years. And I don't miss a soul of a drink. Believe me, those days, it was very tempting. But the good Lord was on my side, and he's been knocking on my door many times, the good Lord. And I haven't been, I'm 72. Well, I've been pretty good. And with the support that I'm having with you guys, I'm very overwhelmed. And I want to be a part of you guys.
We want you here too.
So I have to hang around with my sister whenever she is. But it's nice to know there are people that we could talk and not, you know, feel humiliated. But just, you know, that there's the good Lord is with you. And he's there to help you. And no matter what you do, or a false move, you'll pick up yourself up again and keep on going.
Amen. So you literally kicked it in the can.
Yes, I sure did.
Literally.
I sure did.
Praise the Lord. Only the Lord can take that desire away.
If I could beat cancer, I sure did kick that.
Me
that
too. Cancer. Me too.
Remission of eight years. And it was the good Lord. I praise the Lord for that too. So, you know, don't give up on the Lord.
No, and never.
Keep on going.
You're almost 45.
So, you know, he's the reason I'm here today, because my doctors look at my records and they said, we don't understand. They all say, because I have a lot of specialists, they all say, I don't know how you're still standing. And I said, I do. And I start laughing really loud. I'm like, it's God. I said, you think I'm relying on my strength? I'd be on the floor. It's all God. Amen. So that's a time to give a testimony. Amen. And so his dad, that we've been praying for, the ones that didn't hear that part, you know, he decided he would challenge me to talk about God. Go ahead, shoot. Let me hear it. And I did. And it went real smooth and beautiful. And he received it. And he's saved. Praise God. So, you know, that could be your mistake. If you want to hear me talk about the Lord, make sure you have time. I'm just telling you. Amen. Because I will give you time. Like Karen and I really can, she can vouch for that. I will give you time. And you know what? When the Holy Spirit moves, I don't rush it. I don't rush the conversation. I let God move. But honey, if you ever want to send me a text message, you need some support, feel free. Okay. That's what we're here for. Amen.
Thank you.
So we have one last one, but anybody have anything to say? Because I don't want to rush anybody.
I just want to say to another sister that you just really touched my heart. And thank you so much for sharing.
She's a beautiful person. I can feel her spirit. Beautiful person. I told that to Nett, and she's like, yeah, she is. She's a beautiful person. Because when I see her, even when she says a little bit, and I'm so proud, she's really opening up. But with me, my teachers used to set me up with the quiet ones, because by the end of the year, they would talk people's heads off. So I guess I'm in the right ministry, you know. So, you know, hey, it's a gift of gab, I guess. So the last verse is Revelations 5:13. And after this part of the victory in Jesus is praising God. We got to remember to praise him when we receive our victory. So that's going to be Revelations 5:13.
Okay, that Larry, is.
I believe.
And every creature. Oh, I'm sorry.
Larry.
Oh, Larry.
Go ahead, Larry. I'm sorry.
Go ahead. But you have to turn your sound on.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yep.
Can you hear me now? One thing I want to say, number one, Mike, congratulations on your 30 plus years. You know, only through God can we do that. I have 30 plus years, right?
I'll get 13.
And then
13.
Oh, 13. I'm giving you...
Your badge right
I'm
now.
Giving you the other 27. I'm giving you the other 17 that you're going to get.
Oh, I'll get it.
And Annette's sister's there still.
Mary.
Yes, she is. Huh?
Mary Jane.
Mary Jane, I want to give you praise for letting God speak. You know, speak through you, and for everything that you've done. And one thing that I learned, what God wanted me to do, and it got people all mad at me and everything, but it doesn't matter because God said do it and I do it.
You have to love.
When you stand up there and you give your testimony, or you stand up there and do, you know, give some kind of talk, you say your name is Mary Jane and I am a recovered alcoholic in the name of Jesus. I have recovered.
Amen.
Right? Think that over, right?
Thank the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Because you will be who you claim to be. And if you are claiming to be, and if you're still claiming to be an alcoholic, then you still are the mindset of that alcoholic. But if you claim to be a recovered alcoholic, there will be people coming up to you and saying, how have you got the nerve to say you're recovered? You know, you're recovered, because you'll be recovering for the rest of your life. No. I'm not going to recover for the next 30 years. I am already recovered, and I'm going to enjoy the next 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to stay in Christ, and I'm going to party like crazy in heaven. It's going to be with
on his holy water.
We'll meet you there.
Claim it. Claim sobriety. Praise God for it, and then give it to everybody else that you see in that room.
Well, not only is she recovered like the world thinks of it, she's set free.
Amen.
And who God makes free is free indeed.
Free indeed.
Amen.
So, you know.
Karen was raising her hand, Karen.
Okay, I don't see you. I'm so sorry.
I was praising
God.
Jesus. Okay, well, you can do that all night. I'll be there with you.
You know, like little kids. Ooh, 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 come on.
Daddy G's bringing down the house now.
Maybe we should do jazz hands so everybody knows that's the praise hands.
Well, that means applause in sign language.
Oh, it does? Okay, well then.
Amen. Well, does anybody have anything to add before I close? Because I want everyone to feel like they've had opportunity.
Karen wants to talk.
No, she doesn't.
Just do this. That's counting.
Larry, are you picking on me?
Why is everybody always picking on me?
Picking on you.
When he says that, just give him the praise hands. Amen. We all should be praising. Can I want to ask some of you guys, because I love you all in the body of Christ, and you know that. You know I love you all. Could you, when you come, like when I give these studies, could you think of testimonies to bring? Because, I mean, that just makes us want to celebrate at the end of every one of these, and I just think it's so important. You think you could bring testimonies?
Yes.
Good. Yeah. I appreciate that, because I'd like to start something different, because you'll see that not only will it help unite us since we're talking about these subjects, but also it'll give us strength as a family of Christ, because then someone can look back and say, oh, I remembered when this. Oh, yeah. And, you know, sometimes we tend to forget, you know, how good God is to us. So it's good to write those things down or something to bring something with us, if that's all right. I think that's for it.
Your testimony is somebody else's road to recovery.
Amen. Amen.
And like I say, close the door, kick out the devil. Well, when you put them under your feet, you also kick them out, because when your testimony is like putting them under your feet.
Yes.
You're talking about defeating him, and there's a lot more to defeating to do. That's the awesome part.
Yes.
There's an old pastor that once said that after he had retired. He was going to bed, and he was tired, and he laid his head down, and he just got comfortable in the into his light REM sleep, and all of a sudden he started feeling jittery, and the bed started to shake a little bit, and he threw the covers off, and he looked down at the foot of the bed, and he said, "And I saw Satan." So I took the covers up and I went back to sleep and said, "Oh, it's only you."
Well, if we're on that kind of joke, I have to say something. There was a pastor, true story. So he was talking and giving a service, and then somebody started having like this growl that's coming out of their voice that's not human, and said, I don't remember what he said, but he came out and said something like, I'll get you or something. And the people running out of the church was just sad, because right then we should have started, you know, if it was me, I'd be like, you're not going anywhere. We're going to pray right here. But anyway, the pastor stayed behind. Everybody ran out of the church. And he goes, "Aren't you scared of me with that growling voice?" He goes, "No." He goes, "You know," he said, your mother-in-law, she said, "I know your mother-in-law." So it was a funny story, but that's what happened. You know, why would he be afraid of him if family was related to Satan in his eyes? So anyway, that was the story. In a nutshell, wrap it up tight with a bow. But that devil went home.
Okay, I'm going to read this now.
Okay. One more.
Revelation 5:13, "And every creature which is in heaven and on the earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea and all that are in them, heard I saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb forever and ever and ever."
Amen. You can't have a final victory better than that.
Yep.
Karen and I talk about that. Could you imagine in heaven, and we end up making stories out of it. Before you know, we're over here in left field. Like, oh, could you imagine in the field? And then we start talking about it. And then by the end of the night, we're just smiling so bright, you know? So remember that not only do we have the victory here, because a lot of us are waiting for victory in heaven, we have it here. So every day we could put our praise on. Amen. Because God will help us defeat the enemy with all things in our life. He didn't say that I can do some things through Christ that strengthens me. He says I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. So we'll keep that in mind, because we are warriors. How's that song go? I'm a warrior. Yes, in the army of the Lord, I'm a warrior. warrior in the army of the Lord. I'm a warrior in the army of the Lord. I'm a warrior in the army of the Lord. If I fight, I will fight in the army. And you can go on and on. But anyway, let's pray. We are warriors.
Amen.
Amen. So I pray that you all had a blessed time. I know I did. This message really resonated with me with all I'm going through. And in fact, the enemy tried to attack me before I did this message yesterday. And I finally just got mad enough that I said, Satan, leave me alone, because I'm going to do this message whether you want me to or not, because I'm victorious. That's what God promised me. So we're victorious. We're going to take that. We're going to leave with that today, knowing that we're victorious in God. Amen. We're warriors. So I don't know.
I was trying to find a song that was out, oh gosh, early 1980s. I know once in a while I play some of those songs and that goes yay. Some of you are like, whatever. But
I love
this one here, when you just said he's under my feet. And that, do you remember the song? He's under my feet, the devil's under my feet. I'm trying to find it, and
God's
I can't remember.
Not dead. No way, he is alive. God's not dead. No way.
Oh, yeah, yes, I like that one.
Yeah, God's, I know that one. Dead.
No way. I'm homeschooled. Yeah. I'm old. He is alive. I feel it in my feet.
Oh, thank you.
There you go. I feel it in my head.
I feel it in my feet. I feel it in my arms.
You know the one I like, the old bulldog. I like the old bulldog said, I went to the enemy's camp. And
I just had that. Didn't you play that?
Yes.
I'll play that one here.
You do realize that we're all on tape right now, right?
We love you out there. And if you're enjoying this family of Christ, I encourage you, if you want to know about salvation, leave us a message, contact any one of us, and we will get you right there. And we love you with the love of the Lord. Amen. And we're goofballs for Jesus. So. Anyway, we party without substances. We party with the Holy Spirit, and that's the best partying in the world. So if you want to join us, come Wednesday nights at 7, Sunday nights at 7, and Thursday nights for the women's group at 7. So you remember 7 for all three, you'll be able to find us. Amen?
Amen.
And if you don't have a place you're tithing through, and they're not paying me to say this because nonprofit, but if you don't have a place to tie through, 100% of the donations go for these children in Africa and their families and other areas, the Philippines and India. So that would be a blessing. Give whatever your heart tells you to give, whatever God tells you to give. We don't ask for amount. It's just give what you can, and we appreciate it. So God bless you on that.
Amen.
Anybody can find that old song. I don't remember. It was Kenneth Hagin, Kenneth Copeland. I don't remember who was singing it, but he's under my feet.
I know.
I'll see if I can find it, because it might go with Sunday's message.
What about the enemy's camp one?
It was like a really, it was so cool. It was like, you know, that other one that I talk about where with my favorite scripture. Now I can't remember it. My favorite scripture, right? It's back in the days of put on the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. It's in that same time frame. And
we'll have it for you next week.
Maybe for next week, we'll get the 80s Christian music ready. Because I think all of us know that.
I wish I got to find that song, because it's, I just can't remember it right now. I'll find it. Anyway.
I just might want to record it.
Yeah.
You want to play it?
One of my favorites are Days of Elijah.
Yeah, that's his favorite too.
Yeah.
And he likes it by the Marines, especially.
Oh, the hoo-ah.
Yeah, hoo-ah.
I've seen that one.
Yeah. I love that one. I shared that one.
Okay, well, I guess you can go ahead and close there, girl, okay?
Okay. Does anyone want to close it out? If not, I will. Does anybody want to pray? Okay. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this message, Father God. I thank you for this group that you put together, because I always pray every time we come on, I say, Lord, bring who you have ordained and chosen to be here. Father God. And Lord, I know that the ones that come, that you will bless them, Father God. And Lord, speak to the others that haven't been able to come, Lord, and bring them here, because I fought spiritually to be here, Father, a lot of times. But Lord, I got blessed every time, and people don't realize that whatever we go through is our testimony to others, Father God. So if you can help us, you can help all your other children to get through whatever they're going through. So thank you. And Lord, I pray that this message about victory in Jesus will leave everyone feeling that we are victorious, because we serve a victorious God. We give you the honor and glory, and we pray these things in your precious son, Jesus' name. Amen.
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 I thought that was it. I wanted to play it for you. It's Devil's Under My Feet, but it's not the right one. Oh, well.
Stop searching.
I can't help it. It's in my mind now. Amen. Okay.
See God you. Bless. Maybe for next time. Love y'all.
Okay. God bye bless bye. You. Well, thank you, Joanne.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Coming. I enjoyed our family. I always enjoy our family. I always enjoy our family so much.
Take care, Patty, and Karen. You're gonna get better. Joanne, everybody get better.
Bye, guys.
Good night. Good night, sweetie. Good night.